Welcome to Crayola Creativity Week. Today's theme is writing your story. Our special guests are musician and actor Trinity Bliss, author Lisa Ann Scott, and illustrator Sue Cornelison. Trinity, please tell us how you became an actor and musical recording artist, and how your career at age 14 helps you express your creativity.
Hi there, I'm Trinity Bliss. It's so good to meet you. I started pursuing my creative dreams as a preschooler in summer theater camp, and I was cast in the Avatar movie, Avatar: The Way of Water, as Tupide when I was 7 years old. My creativity is kind of tied to my curiosity, which I feel like I get a lot of that from my mom, and she immigrated to the United States from China as a graduate student. To study aerospace engineering, in fact, which is really cool. And she's always asking questions, and I try to do that and learn from her. I love to express myself through acting and music and writing. My parents are super supportive of my being an actor and singer and songwriter, and I'm really grateful to them, but they are also very focused on my education. Even after a long day of filming, they'll make sure I sit down and spend time on my homework, especially like my half an hour math, before allowing me to pick up my guitar and let my music tell my story.
Lisa Ann, please tell us what inspired you to write children's books that focused on self-reflection and storytelling.
Hello, I'm Lisa Ann Scott, and I can remember the exact moment that I decided I wanted to be a writer. I was 7 years old, and I was in second grade, and I was a voracious reader. I absolutely loved books. And one day our teacher said, "Now I want you guys to write a story today." And it was like, boom, wow, just so exciting. I never thought about writing a story before. And I just knew in that moment, I mean, I can remember sitting in the desk like I'm still there, I'm going to be a writer someday. And it turns out that I didn't really start writing for publication until I was in my 40s. But sometimes dreams do take a while. You never give up. And one day, a few years ago, I had a decision to make, and I just didn't know what to do. And I remember thinking, oh, do I want this to be part of the story of my life? And it was like lightning bolt. Oh my gosh, what a great idea for a children's story. Like, that's so powerful. I knew that I wanted to write for children, and I knew that I wanted to write the kind of books that I loved reading, especially ones that help you make sense of the world, sometimes change who you are because of what you read. And so this story helps show kids that all the things you do, the daily actions and the decisions you make, it defines your personal story. It's your story. When you get to the end of your life, you will look back and everything you said and do made up that story. And the really cool part of it is nobody can tell you who you are. It's all up to you. So we each have a special way of being brave, being kind, and dealing with mistakes, and speaking up boldly. And I love helping kids be more aware of the impact that each of us has on other people by thinking of themselves as the star of their own story. And I think that's really pretty powerful.
Sue, please tell us what inspired you to become an illustrator and why this book is so important.
Hi, I'm Sue Cornelison. I love to illustrate children's books that have a message worth sharing. As a child, I drew all the time. I was always drawing and painting. Bringing Lisa Ann's poem to life with images of diverse children making the daily decisions that shape their personal lives was an absolute joy. This was such a special book, and I was honored to be asked to be the illustrator.
Lisa Ann, please read the book, The Story of You.
The Story of You by Lisa Ann Scott. That's me. You're writing a story with everything you do. What's this story about? It's the story of you. When you choose to be kind, when you decide to share, when you reach out a hand, when you make sure it's fair, you're writing the story of you. When you are bold and brave, when you choose something new, when you try though it's hard, when you learn what to do, you're writing the story of you. When you ask for a hug, when you offer one too, when you're first to step up, when you find a new view, you're writing the story of you. When you search and explore, when you hatch a big plan, when you find your own beat, when you shout, "Yes, I can," you're writing the story of you. when you offer to help, when you make awesome things, when you meet a new friend, when you try out your wings, you're writing the story of you. When you're not sure what's right, when you're filled with regret, when you can't find your voice, when you're mad, don't forget, you're writing the story of you. When you say what is true, when you're jealous but cheer, when you're scared but speak up, when you're lost but still steer, you're writing the story of you. When you show what you know, when you follow your heart, when you do your own thing, when you're ready to start, you're writing the story of you. When you share the best you, when you break from the crowd, when you make a hard choice, when you feel strong and proud, you're writing the story of you. You were born to create a story all your own. The chapters never end, not even when you're grown. The story of you tells the world who you are. So what happens next? That's up to you. You are what you do. You're the star of the story of you.
Wow, what a great story. Lisa Ann, please tell us about the main messages in the book.
There are several lines from the book that I want to focus on. When you try, though it's hard, when you hatch a big plan, when you try out your wings, you're writing the story of you. Life is filled with unexpected situations, and our decisions can fill us with uncertainty. But that's okay, as long as every day, in every way, you share the best you. The line that really sums it all up is, you were born to create a story all your own. I want kids to reflect on their daily actions and be proud of the story that their behaviors and attitudes write. It's really a powerful idea, something that you can refer to when you're trying to decide what to do. Ask yourself, do I want this to be part of my story?
Trinity, Lisa Ann talked about the importance of reflecting on our behaviors and decisions. How does this insight fit with the stories in your life?
I feel like through all of our behaviors and decisions and the people we surround ourselves with, the world we live in and how we see that world is all reflected in our little window of creativity and how we express ourselves. We're so much more alike than we are different, all of us, and music and even acting too is a way for us all to connect. And aside from those, being creative and just in our everyday life, we're writing our story and making our mark on our world and our society. I remember reading the story of you and I loved, there was one line about the hugs you take and then the hugs you offer, and I'm a big hug person and just like very family oriented, and I feel like in my songs when expressing love or how I see the world, that's part of me writing my story. Even Tuke's experience and her family, Sully stick together is a big motto in their family. And they stick together through and through and are there for each other through all the hardships. And I feel like that's really my family too. And I love my family so much. They're the most important thing to me. And we definitely stick together through and through. No matter what happens, even when my brothers grow up and they're older than me and they're living in different places or far away, we'll call each other and we're together and just always have each other's back. And I think that's a beautiful way that art imitates life when we see our families on the screen. It is interesting too, I find that when acting, you're in this character and you're putting your all into this character and into their experiences and the world that they are in, and using your whole imagination and putting yourself in their shoes. Whereas music is such a vulnerable, honest thing. I see many connections in the stories I perform. I feel like the more of us who share our stories and come together to share that story, the more our messages are heard and projected into the world.
That is a lovely introduction to our first art activity. Trinity, please describe your songwriting process and show us how to illustrate lyrics that tell a personal life story.
I think the lyrics I'm going to draw a picture of right now from the outro section of California Sun. Maybe I'll cite the lyrics for you. It goes, one day I'll fall in love in the California sun, on the beach when it's almost sunset. California sun, California sun. That's kind of how the song ends, and I felt like it ends on a hopeful note and about the future and how California will always be a home and a hope and light to me. For this lyric, I really wanted to paint that picture of the sunset and the beach. When I'm writing my lyrics, I love to draw and just kind of like word cloud my songs. It really helps me find my feelings and my message. And even the melodies and the rhythm and the chords that I use all reflect just this color and the feeling and the stage that the song is setting and kind of getting across. I'm gonna try to draw waves, like maybe just a little texture in the water. Looks okay. It's like a yellow. I'm starting to draw the sun. I'm gonna try not to combine the blue with yellow, but it might be a little green, and that's okay. I'm going in with a little orange because I think that might create the sun halo that often see in the California sun. I'm gonna blend it out. Try to create a little sunset in the back. Remember to tune in to today's afternoon assembly, where I will join other creative thought leaders. I look forward to singing the song we just illustrated, California Sun, and showing how my creativity flows through my music. Very excited.
Thank you, Trinity. Sue, please demonstrate how to create a scene where viewers can insert themselves as the star in your own story.
So we're going to start by writing star of your story at the top of the page. And I'll be sketching the little girl in the book, but you'll be drawing yourself, doing any activity that you choose. Start with her forehead, okay? And I put the nose, it's tilted up a little bit. There's an angle here. So the line goes through her mouth. I'm going to draw a big smile. She's pretty happy about being the star of her story. She's the lead role. Her eyes are slightly closed. She's looking down, so like upside down rainbows. Now the fun part, I get to do hair. And her hair is blowing in the wind because she's running downhill. Now she has her arms up in the air. So just draw a little shoulder, and she's kind of almost like dancing. I have her fingers kind of like ballet hands. And you can decide what's your favorite color. Let's see, we're gonna make her shirt green. So when you're drawing, sometimes it helps to have a photo reference. You could pull in a photo or look at photo references of yourself. With different facial expressions or doing an activity. Maybe your favorite thing to do is play soccer. Maybe you love to play basketball or play a musical instrument or draw. So if you had a photo of yourself doing your favorite activity, that's helpful. And you can also look at yourself in the mirror and making different facial expressions if you want to show happy. Smile at yourself if you want to show sad. You can make those emotions and take a look at your face and see what happens. That's what I do sometimes when I want to do subtle, get subtle emotions in my characters. Now, we're talking about the story of you. So each of us have special gifts, treasures within us. And I thought about what mine might be. With this project. And I was thinking that when I was young, little, I always loved to hunt for rocks. I don't know why, it was just, rocks were just beautiful to me. And I loved to collect rocks. I had all kinds. And I think when I think about it now, it's because I loved finding the beauty in small things in nature, things that other people might not see. We're gonna make a little pocket. I have some from Crayola, I have some wonderful pattern paper here, and I thought it'd be really fun to cut out a pocket. Just cut out a little square, fold down the top, and we can glue that pocket right to the shirt. And within that pocket, we can put our special hidden treasure of our personality that we all have. We all have something. Maybe you can find a way to work a pocket into the drawing of you and put in your special hidden treasure. So when you're drawing yourself as the star of your own story, you can make it personal to you. Draw what you really love to do.
Thank you, Sue, Trinity, and Lisa Ann for helping us see why writing your own story through your actions, art, and music is so important.
Thank you, Julia. It was great to be with you all today. Bye.
Goodbye.
Thanks, Julia. Bye.
Parents and educators, be sure to check out more creative ideas at crayola.com/creativityweek. And remember to share kids' artwork. Post a photo on social media using #CrayolaCreativityWeek for a chance to win today's amazing giveaway.